What's up, guys? My name's Trey. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I actually have a fun little video based on the title. It may feel a little gimmicky because it says how to get better at jiu-jitsu when you can't train jiu-jitsu. So obviously within that context, guys, I'm thinking more in the realm of obviously you could train Monday and Wednesday, but you can't Tuesday, you can't Thursday, you can't Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, fill in the blank. So obviously you've got 2 days a week that you could actually improve at jiu-jitsu because those are the only times that you could train. Well, I've actually got a couple fun, easy ways that you guys can actually improve in jiu-jitsu without actually being physically at the gym training jiu-jitsu. Because believe it or not, being in the jiu-jitsu gym is not the only place you guys can actually train jiu-jitsu. And I'll tell you, myself training full-time every single day from teaching class to having my own sessions for myself, cross-training, going to other gyms, I train all the time on the mat. On top of that though, I actually train off the mat as well. Not just within lifting weights, which is a phenomenal way to get better at jiu-jitsu, right? Anything you could do to increase flexibility, mobility, joint health, strength in general, because let's be real, where technique is equal or someone's slightly above you or you're slightly above them, strength is either the great equalizer or it's a great tiebreaker. It's something you don't obviously want to rely on, but it's helpful. So obviously with lifting weights, getting stronger off the mat is gonna be something that's super beneficial to you. More so in my mind, I think in the context of what's gonna keep me healthy long-term, especially with my shoulders, hips, knees, all that fun stuff like that. The biggest one though that I've found that has been the most helpful to me is actually studying film, okay? Now, obviously we all have our different games, what we prefer to do, whether you prefer to take down, get on top, pass, look for the back, or you like to pull guard, look for sweeps, set up Dela Riva, worm guard, pretty much whatever guard you're looking to go to, we all have a general pathway that we try to get to, right, in our game. What's great about that, though, is that it is 2021 right now. And in 2021, there is so much information that's available out there between BJJ Fanatics or other people that actually have their own websites. Like, I think even Homolo has his own website where he teaches technique. You know, our professor of our association, Kyle Terra, has his own website where he teaches his technique, he shares his curriculum and everything of that nature, right? And it's absolutely phenomenal. Now, normally, historically, right, you'd have to be where? You'd have to be in California or somewhere in Texas, wherever they may be, to get knowledge from these people that are like 3-time, 4-time, 10-time world champions. Like, you're talking about like the game of telephone when you're taught jiu-jitsu in a lot of cases, right? You obviously have the source from someone who's a super high level. They teach somebody, they teach somebody, they teach somebody. And historically, that's how jiu-jitsu has always been taught. But now we actually have the availability of actually getting it from the direct source, right? Which is pretty darn neat. Now, that doesn't mean that, hey, I can just get on YouTube or BJJ Fanatics and train in my garage with my, you know, my brother, and then I'm gonna be like a jiu-jitsu world class or do super well, right? I'm not saying it's impossible for you not to get better that way. But you need training partners and you need a coach that can help guide you to get you to obviously where you need to be. But getting better off the mat, guys, studying film is actually one of the craziest, easiest, best ways I've actually found to improve at jiu-jitsu pretty darn quick. So for example, what that process looks for me is that I actually have a specific style that I really enjoy. I really enjoy pulling guard. I enjoy sweeping, getting on top, and passing. Like, I enjoy passing, I enjoy sweeping, but I really enjoy playing guard, especially against some of my friends that are super good at judo, right? Because I grew up wrestling, I'll go in for a shot, they're super good at defending, and whoop, they're looking to foot sweep me. So what's a good remedy to judo? Get a good guard pull. So as long as you have a good guard, you can sweep him, get on top, guess what? You're gonna be looking pretty good and having a lot of fun. But what I do, guys, and what that looks like is that when I'm not training, I actually will watch film. And I'll study specific people that play the game that I enjoy, or let's say I have a specific problem that I'm struggling with, right? So let me give you an example. I actually have one of my coaches, his name's Nick, he's a really talented black belt. This guy is super good at over-under, double-under, like pressure style passing. And with me, I attack the legs a lot. Not necessarily like with an ankle locks or like anything of that nature, like attacking leg locks, but more in the context of like, I like Dela Riva. You know, I like playing guards that are related to my legs, attacking their legs to sweep and get on top, right? To off balance them. Well, he plays a passing style that only gives like the upper body, right? So a lot of my progression, which if I thought a little hindsight, maybe it would have been better for me to, you know, study a little bit more framing initially, right? Then go into spider guard or other things that focus just on the upper body, right? But a lot of my progression was then learning, okay, well, when I get to half guard, what could I use to actually help me better sweep and actually combat a lot of his pressure style passing, right? So I studied a lot of Adam Orzinski because he has a really strong and good half guard that he uses to go to butterfly, and he has a lot of success sweeping and fighting a lot of people that way, right? So, you know, I ended up getting the guy's instructional, studying it. It was actually pretty helpful. But what I found to be most helpful to be watching was actually him competing, right? So I got on YouTube, free information that's out there, and I researched the mess out of the guy, and I would actually drill it by myself, and then I would situationally spar with that, which I think is the most important part with drilling. And I think some of us get mixed up with drilling, because with drilling, a lot of people think it's, okay, my turn, great. Your turn, great. Your turn, great, and there's zero resistance, right? But the best form of drilling I've found that's combined with that, like when you're initially learning it, is actually starting in that position and having your partner do a specific reaction that's gonna kind of, you know, test you and push you a little bit so you could feel some actual live resistance. It's like Andrew Wilty talks a lot about like pressure testing your technique, right? And you can do that through cross training and competing, but I found that it can be done pretty well within also drilling as well when you're like situational sparring. So when you learn and you start understanding a system of like, for example, whether you're sweeping or passing somebody, you generally will have a couple pathways you can go, right? So if your partner does one thing, you're gonna do one thing. If your partner does another to counter that, then you're gonna do something else that would what? Counter that. So what you do is that after you've drilled and you kind of got a, like a good understanding of where you go when your partner puts up certain roadblocks or does certain things or puts weight on one way or puts weight in the other, you're gonna be able to pressure test that in that drilling session by situationally sparring. And the reason why I like to view it as drilling, guys, because it's very controlled and it puts you in a very niche position that it gives you opportunity to actually get better. And I'm telling you guys, you'll get better super fast, okay? I was able to take and drill and work through studying K-guard from a position I didn't understand, didn't know how to do well, to then 6 to 7 weeks later, I was able to do it actually quite proficiently at higher belts. I even used it at Nogi Pan Ams, was able to submit my opponent with a toe hold from there. It went phenomenally well. Now, just keep in mind, when I say 6 to 7 weeks, I'm training every single day, right? And I'm studying it every single day. Now, I have kids, I have a wife, and I love them. I give them all of my attention, but instead of playing like Xbox or something of that nature, like I'm studying film, right? So you need a little bit of context to that. So when you study a guard or a sweep or a pass or a takedown, something you're really researching and watching, it may take you a little bit longer, okay? So I don't want you to think like timestamps on stuff, but when you guys are off the mat, how you get better at jiu-jitsu when you can't train? Well, you study film, okay? So the two easiest ways, guys, is number one, pay attention to what you're putting into your body and get stronger, like work out off the mat, guys. The other way, which is super easy, study film, okay? It's gonna help grow your knowledge. It's gonna give you something to chew on, think on, and I hope you guys have the same experience that I did, because it has actually grown my love and curiosity for jiu-jitsu. And I've noticed that as I've learned from different perspectives outside of just my coach or Kyo, I've actually found listening to different people like Mikey Musumeci or, you know, Gordon Ryan or some of the other people that you'll find that have a lot of these instructionals, guys, it's pretty darn neat, okay? Hope you guys have a good day. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, guys. Like the video. Let me know down below, guys, how you guys actually generally see the best results of getting better. For me, guys, studying film, drilling, and situational sparring has been like the icing on the cake. So I'm very curious to hear about your experience. Well, Belk. My goodness, I'm not even gonna edit that out. What belt rank are you guys? How long have you been training jiu-jitsu? I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.